Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Deauville Racecourse here on Sunday. It's the 31st of May, 2020. Going to look at all the stakes races on the program from Deauville, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for racecourses around the world, and also join me tomorrow for my French 2000 Guineas preview here from Deauville and the 1000 Guineas to Pouliot and the Poulains. So join me for that, and also the return of the racing from the UK at Newcastle. Basically, just join me on YouTube this week. Great racing tomorrow with the Guineas and the return of Newcastle. And then Friday, you have the Coronation from Newmarket and the Lingfield Derby and Oaks Trial. Saturday, the Guineas from Newmarket and 1000 Guineas Sunday. And the return of racing here in New York at Belmont. It doesn't get any better than that, so basically, join me for all those previews. I can't wait. But great card today from Deauville. We'll be looking at all the stakes races. Races 4, 5, 6, and 7. So let's get to it. The fourth race, it's the Prix de Suresnes Stakes. It's listed stakes going for a purse $43,000. Race for 3-year-olds. Field of 6 horses going 2,000 meters or a mile and a quarter on the turf course. My top selection here, I'm going to take the number 4 horse, Ocean Atlantic. I'm going to go 4-2-1 in the Tri-Cast Trifecta. 4-2-1 Tri-Cast Trifecta. Top selection 4 horse, Ocean Atlantic. 3-0 colt by American Pharaoh. Coolmore owned, Andre Farb trains. Pierre Charles Bedeau gets to mount. The horse's most recent outing came the 14th of May at Longchamp. Mile and 8th, 1800 meters into Group 3 Prix La Force. And the horse finished second by 1.5 lengths. He quickened up a little bit that day from the inside, but it wasn't anything spectacular. Also, he didn't have the best beginnings, even though wasn't his fault. He got kind of squeezed at the start, but he closed up a little bit. First off the break, I think he needed the race, getting the extra 1/8 of a mile or 200 meters today to the 2,000 or a mile and a quarter trip. Second off the break, I think it'll be a lot fresher, and I think he's sitting on a very good run. Before that, the horse ran the 16th of October at Saint-Cloud, 1 mile main race, and he finally, you know, he took off clear on the front end, winning by 8 lengths, finally breaking the maiden. That was a very good, easy run. Before the main race at Saint-Cloud, going the mile trip in mid-September, the 18th, finished second by length there, and he never really got going until late. He just couldn't stay. You know, it wasn't his day to win. I think he had a lot of two-year-old antics there, but I thought he's improved with every single race. He's drawn well. He should definitely get the mile a quarter, and I think he'll get the going also. He's proven he can run on heavy ground. Also, he can run on a little bit of quicker ground. I think you'll see somewhere in the between today, but I like him here. Let's take him. So to recap my selection for the fourth from Deauville, it's Prix de Suresnes, or Serenes, or whatever you say it. I'm going to go with the four horse, Ocean Atlantique. I'm going to go 4-2-1 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta to the fifth race. Race number 5 from Deauville, it's the Prix de Lille Stakes. It's listed stakes going for a purse $43,000, race for 3-year-olds only. We have a field of 11 horses entered to go the 1,600-meter journey or 1 mile on the turf course. My top selection, we'll take the 7-horse Bionic Woman. We'll go 7-2 in the Forecast Exacta. 7-2, Forecast Exacta. Top selection, 7-horse Bionic Woman. This Godolphin 3-0 filly by Loop de Vega. Andre Farb trains. Miguel Barcelona gets to mount. The horse's most recent outing came in condition. Race on 13th May at Chunti, yielding ground 1 mile there. He finished 4th by 4 lengths, didn't break so well that day, and he really was behind the A ball, a little bit wide, never really quickened up. It wasn't the day to win. Second off the break, back to Deauville, where the horse ran a decent race back in the summer last year. I'm going to give her another shot. Two back, the horse ran against two tough competition, the Group 1 Prix Marcel Boussac and Longchamp, 1 mile October the 6th, finished 4th by 2.25 lengths, wheels are spinning, wet ground, also, it was just too tough a competition, really wasn't going to get the victory there, and before that, main race, Saint-Cloud, 7 furlongs, the horse won by 1.5 lengths there, and did everything right, stalked, got the lead, and he held on to a very nice victory. The race here at Deauville, I thought this horse would have won her debut going 7.5 around the turn, where she finished 2nd by 0.5 length, but the problem was, or excuse me, 1.5 lengths, the problem was she was drawn so wide, she never really saved ground, and I think you need to save ground on the turf course here, also on the all-weather, that's been another day, but she never saved ground, and I think that cost her late, but I still thought she ran a decent race there from where she was drawn. Going to take her again here at 3-1, second off the break, she's drawn well, let's give her a shot. So to recap my selection for the fifth from Deauville, it's the Prix Lille. Going to go with the number 7 horse here, Bionic Woman, and we'll go 7-2 in the Forecast Exacta. So now let's get to the sixth race from Deauville, which is the Group 2 Grand Prix de Chantilly. It's Group 2 race going for a purse $101,500, race for 4-year-olds and upwards. 6 horses are entered to go 2,400 meters. or the mile and a half trip on the turf course. Top selection here, I think, are likely winners, the one horse French King. We'll go 1-5-2 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 1-5-2 Tri-Cash Trifecta. That's going to be the only way to real make money with this one. But the top selection is one horse French King, 5-year-old horse by French 15. Olivier Pellier gets the mount, the veteran. The horse's most recent outing happened at Doha in Qatar, 22nd of February, a mile and a half in their local group one. And he won by 2.5 lengths, drawn on the inside, quickened up nicely in the front end. It was a very easy run. Major improvement off the start before it came to the group one, Prix de l'Arc de Triomphe. Longchamp going with a mile and a half. He finished ninth by a dozen lengths there, and he really never got a good run. He just couldn't keep up with the better horses, but that was his only fault in 2019. Other than that, he was pretty perfect. He won the Prix von Berlin at Hofgarten, going with 2,400, winning by length very easily there. Then before that, Hamburg and the Group 2 race there, he won by 2.5 lengths, again, very easily. Won at Cologne in Germany, and then won in Doha in Qatar. So he was a little bit globetrotting. He didn't get a lot of victories starts in France, but he was winning in Europe quite nicely. Come back here to Deauville today. Should definitely get the mile and a half. He's drawn well. I think he's a very likely winner, so let's take him. So to recap my selection for the six from Deauville, it's to Group 2 Grand Prix de Chantilly. Let's take the one-horse French King. We'll go 1-5-2 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. So now let's get to the seventh race from Deauville, which is the Group 2 Prix du Gros Chenier Stakes. It's a Group 2 race going for a purse $101,500, raced for 3-year-olds and upwards. We have a field of 9 horses dashing the distance of ground of 1,000 meters or 5 furlongs on the turf course. Top selection, I like the 5 horse Gold Vibe. We'll go 5-2 in the Forecast Exacta. 5-2 Forecast Exacta. Top selection of 5 horse Gold Vibe. The 7-year-old gelding by Jerome Ahead. Christian Demiro's on this one for Pascal Batty. The horse's most recent now it came on the 11th of May at Longchamp. Heavy ground, 5 furlongs in the Group 3, Prix de Saint-Georges, and the horse finished second by a half length, and he really was moving late. He just missed at the end, but first off the break, I thought he ran a respectable race. Come back here to Deauville, looking for his first victory since 2018. I'm going to give him a massive shot. Before that, the horse ran the Group 1, Prix d'Alabay de Longchamp at Longchamp, 5 furlongs on Arc Day. He finished 6 by 6 and a quarter lengths there, and he lost the Glass Slipper 2 starts in a row. Glass Slipper loves that 5/8 mile track at Longchamp, but this horse wasn't getting into it. You know, just ran a little bit a too tough competition. Also, high weight of 136 pounds wasn't to his liking. Two back in the Group 1, it's going to be Group 3 Prix Petit Couvert at Longchamp, going the 5 furlongs or 1,000 meters. He finished 3rd by 1.5 lengths, and I thought he ran decently. The horse has run a little bit better on lower there at Longchamp over the 5 furlongs, run that better race. From where he was drawn, I thought he ran a terrific one, and then over this 5 furlongs here at Deauville last summer in a list stakes, finished 3rd by 2.25 lengths by Ken Colt's extra one in the back of one today. It came up a very tough listed stakes that day, but he held his own out. But he was facing the toughest of the tough horses, at this 5-furlong trip last year. This race is not nearly as tough as the renewal last year. Back here to Deauville, where I thought he ran a sneaky good race in July, I'm going to give him a shot here at 4-1. So to recap my selection for the second from Deauville, it's to Group 2 Prix de Gros de Chenier. Let's take the 5-horse Gold Vibe, but we'll go 5-2 in the Forecast Exacta. So good luck to him. Please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5. Good luck, everybody.